Well, hey guys, this is Keith from over at Pop-Up Filmcast. Nate, I have a nice vintage copy of Animorphs number 2. I just need the address. I need the Headline Heroes office address in order to send this to you, because honestly, I don't know anybody else who deserves it more, or well, maybe would want it. Anyway, keep up the good work. Somebody DM me that address, because this thing's just collecting dust here waiting for you. All right, vintage Animorphs number 2. You guys keep it up. Thanks.
Hello and welcome to issue number, I think this is 75 of Headline Heroes. A comedy podcast where we take today's headlines, create a comic book origin story. My name is Drew Mick.
I'm Nathan Haynes.
And I'm Tanner Ackerman. Can I let my tag?
I was going to say, and here's the fourth host.
New fourth host. Tanner's cat, whose name I don't know.
Want to introduce? I think there's Buckethead is one of the cats. And then
we got Buckethead. We got Pinchy.
Yeah.
And Salem.
Oh, obviously named after
after my favorite city.
Oh, I was gonna say the Olympic, the Winter Olympic sports, but that's a slalom.
Damn it, that was what I too.
You misspelled it on the birth certificate.
I was like, well, fuck, I'm stuck with it now.
Salem.
That's the law.
Yeah. So can we get Keith that office address?
We already did.
Oh,
actually, so. Sent him my home address. So I know they tell you not to do that with people you meet on the internet, but God damn it, I did it anyway.
And you
did not tell my wife. That is fine.
For that sweet, sweet Animorph merch.
Mm-hmm. Well, sorry, what was that?
You did it for the sweet, sweet Animorph merch. So I mean, if Libby doesn't understand that.
When you come across a sick collector's item like that, you don't, I mean, collecting dust. no, that would not do. So now it's in my bookcase. Protected from the elements.
Does it still not get dust even on a bookcase?
Oh, not as much. I mean, because of the doors. Because there's old, they have old
also
doors
that shelf
on the bookcase.
Oh, okay.
You got one of the enclosed bookshelf. I see.
Mm-hmm. Do you want me to go get it? I could read to you from it.
Yeah, you go get it.
Yeah, okay.
All right.
I hope. Oh, he's actually doing it.
Hey, Tanner, how do we kick Nate from a phone call?
We
can do it, actually. Let's play with it. Hold on.
Alt F4.
Right click on him. Ooh, no. Oh, I can't do anything.
Found it, guys.
All right.
Found it.
Damn it. I can't. Damn
fuck.
It. I
didn't
can't
do it in time.
Him.
Hope you're ready.
I can add people. Let's see. Maybe if we add enough people, it'll clog
here.
Up the.
Guys?
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Oh, did you not wait?
Oh, yeah. We moved on and we. So, Tanner, you want to wrap it up here?
Yeah, and that was our hero, Voltron, the cat. That turns into five cats.
Yeah.
Animorphs. Megamorphs number 2.
Fuck.
In the Time of Dinosaurs by K.A. Applegate.
Is this one a dinosaur one?
So yeah, apparently this is the Animorphs subtitle Megamorphs number 2.
Oh.
So this is about, this isn't the time of dinosaurs though. So like we're getting prehistoric here.
I was going to say, if they're already doing dinosaurs by the second one, they fucking ran out of ideas after one book.
Let's see. We got, I don't know, hawk, dog, what else is there? I don't know, dinosaurs?
T-Rex.
Yeah, okay.
Let's get that in there. Yeah, where do they go once if you do all the animals in the past, because the only animals in the past are, of course, dinosaurs. I guess we go to future animals, so then they can just make up shit.
Yeah, then they can do cyber dragons.
Nate, correct me if I'm wrong, but did Keith also send us something else?
He did. Nice little surprise when I carefully opened up the Animorphs book with my specialty book tools so as not to crease the pages.
Yeah.
I noticed that he had left one of his artist renderings of one of our of Carnival, one of our creations. So I have that is in my possession currently.
That is something.
I was very surprised to see that. So thank you. It's signed by the artiste himself as well.
Yes. So thank you, Keith. That we'll get that framed and. Yeah, and that is something we actually tweeted out when he sent it to us, so we could retweet that out, actually, probably.
Don't worry, Keith, I'm going to make sure I blur out your address. I noticed that the pictures I took did have your address in it.
Oh. Is the book in good condition? Any foxing around the edges or anything?
No, it's actually in remarkably good condition. Wow. It's got a little bit of a top of the spine. There is a little bit of the paper missing, but that's fine. It shows character, I think, personally.
It's the kind of damage that increases the value, I guess.
Exactly. It's when you know, like, you know how when book gets shittier, sometimes they're better.
David, it just like whew, went up.
Now it's like a Banksy thing.
Yeah. That's maybe more appropriate and more modern.
Banksy comes in your house, just fucks up your books.
Remember how on David, he used to have a bigger dick, but then it went through that shredder.
That was part of the pedestal. Yeah.
Small, yeah.
I was going to say something else. Oh, shit.
Oh. It was about that statue's small dick.
Yeah, it was about that.
It probably was.
About that. Speaking of Keith. I was just on the latest episode of his podcast, the Pop-Up Filmcast. It was a blast. Me and Keith and Derek, the two hosts there, we just pitched fictitious movies. Mine was called The Dolphin's Dog, and it was a real heart-wrenching story. It was an action movie, so be prepared. And then at the end, we all pitch our three movies, and then we create a Pop-Up Filmcast for these three movies, and it was a blast. What were you going to say?
That sounds like a lot of fun. And that's out right now, you
said,
right?
It is out now. It came out October 30th.
Very nice.
Yeah. Nice.
Yeah. Well, thank you again, Keith, for your gifts. And everyone, go check out that episode of the Pop-Up Filmcast that Drew was on.
And just his podcast. It's fun.
And just in general, yeah.
Yeah, just general.
Listen, if you're loyal to the Headline Heroes brand, you're going to listen to one fucking episode. And it's the most recent one Drew's on, and that's it. You understand me?
Yeah,
we're drawing a line in the sand right here, damn it.
Actually, if you're listening to this, when this episode comes out on Tuesdays, his episodes also come out on Tuesdays. So be on the lookout.
So you
want
to go skip back an episode. Don't listen to the latest one.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, okay, no. He gave us so much things.
We are, of course, kidding. Listen to all of it.
Of course, kidding.
No. Well... For those of you who are listening to our podcast and our podcast alone, Nate, can you tell them what we do here? Because they probably never listened, I suppose. I don't know.
They probably never heard me say this 74 other times.
Yeah.
But if they listen to other podcasts, they can't listen to what Nate's about to say. Is that what you're saying?
Well, maybe they listen to other podcasts, and it's just so much to comprehend what people do on each of their podcasts. So,
okay, that makes more sense.
I think Nate needs to do that thing. Plus, I got hit in the head as a child by a donkey, so I forget.
It was that goose, wasn't it?
It was the goose poop.
Got up in there.
It was goose poop, yeah. I fell, and I bonked my head, and I got goose poop all over my best shirt. Damn, that far.
Still have not found a replacement for that shirt. Wearing it to this day.
I'm still hunting down that goose, goddammit. Please tell them what we do here.
Please. I of course, will save us and you from the goose poop. So, Drew, every week what we do here is we get submissions of articles from around the internet. We sort of troll around the internet ourselves and find strange and bizarre headlines. And we use these headlines. We throw them in a list. We pick one at random and make a origin story for a superhero or a supervillain out of it. Now, Tanner, last week, what did we make and what are we making this week? I tried really hard to remember what we did, and I couldn't.
Okay. Well, last week... was, of course, our Halloween spooktacular.
Mm-hmm.
So we made a very spooky villain this year. The previous year was a hero. And she went by the name of Murder Vision.
Now, I want to jump in. I want to jump in because while editing and since then, I thought of a better name.
Oh, shit. For real?
Yeah, this is the first. What if we call her Spooktacles?
Ah, fuck!
That was...
Well, now you got to go back through and edit that in, Drew.
I mean, on this podcast that we do, we have the power to be like, hey, do an executive order and say that we can change the name.
But it's already in the episode.
But now it's in this episode.
What if people just quit listening at that episode and never come back?
Well, then they're really missing out. Damn it. They went over to Pop-Up Filmcast.
We warned you.
I know.
Yeah, Spooktacles is dope, but I still want to call the comic book Murder Vision.
It's Murder Vision starring Spooktacles.
Maybe that's her power. She has Murder Vision. I don't know. That implies that she has like Medusa stare.
She's just looking at someone and they die.
We really didn't think that one out. I think we were just like, yeah, whatever. Murder Vision.
People died as like a result of her. People were dying, right?
Yeah. Yeah. But it's not like she... Murder and vision implies that she looks at them and they die, or she looks and sees murders that other people don't, I guess.
Yeah, it didn't make much sense. Damn, you're really putting us on blast here.
It's myself as well. But anyway.
All right, so Drew's blasting himself just as much as he's blasting us.
You know? I love to blast myself.
Retcon. Last week we made spooktacles.
Oh shit, I can do the retcon alert.
Oh fuck. You want to put it in before I said that?
I'll do it right now.
Oh, okay.
That's the sound that a retcon. Police. That's the sound that a beast. That's the sound that a retcon. Police. That's the sound that a beast. That's the sound that a retcon. Man, I hope I still have that. Well, if I don't, then that's real awkward in Dead Space. But anyway.
And we're back. Okay. I guess we're gonna keep going. This week we're gonna do a hero because last week we did a villain.
Yeah.
And I've already picked an article at random for us, and it is number 5 for you guys. That headline is, suspected drug dealer now hasn't been for a poo for 34 days as prison toilet strike continues.
Whoa. Now, right away, I can hear all the haters out there saying, you guys said you weren't going to do any articles about poop. Now, distinctly, this person says they have not gone to the bathroom. They have not pooped in 34 days. Not. So,
and also,
complete opposite.
The person wasn't, this person wasn't arrested for, oh, wait, hold on.
Well, they were arrested.
Toilets.
Yeah, wow. I was going to say, ooh,
damn.
Boy.
Well, no, I think the key thing here is that arrested before the poop stuff happened.
Yes.
Right.
We're going to focus on the drugs.
Superintendent gotten some big deep doo-doo on that one.
What if we just did a hero that got deep? We just did a deep dive on the war on drugs and its failure and like drug culture in America.
That's really funny.
Do you have you guys looked at the article at all yet? Have you seen why he hasn't pooped?
No.
Can you just give it? Can you tell us why? So everyone at home can hear it.
He's been holding it because they're waiting for him to excrete drugs. They believe he swallowed, so that's why he's a suspected drug dealer.
So he's just wow, that is insane. The perfect opportunity to create a superhero
because all the drugs he swallowed,
because all the drugs and he's holding them in. I don't think that's how that
he's
works.
He's trying to eat all the drugs and save everybody else from them.
That's like trying to avoid a breathalyzer by eating a urinal cake, but no, that's not how that works.
The cops were like, clearly they're not drunk, otherwise they wouldn't have eaten that urinal cake.
I needed a mint fast.
Did you guys see this shit about halfway down the page from this news corporation where there's this woman holding a basket of let's hear, bran and other sort of fruits and vegetables and what they call a hamper of natural laxatives. We tried to deliver a hamper of natural laxatives on day 29 of his poo strike, but officers in Essex politely declined. As though he would have... What the fuck are they doing that for? Oh, he didn't want to eat it, and the officers wouldn't let us. I wonder why.
I'm too distracted by the ads on the side because there's literally 5 naked women.
Oh, what? No. Tell me where the article is that's showing you this.
An article. It's an advertisement.
Gotta
hate to see that. Boy, is there a way for me to screen share with you guys?
Why this sneak attack? Man smeared peanut butter on his crotch before bulldog ate his genitals. Why? Why am I being forced to look at this?
What is the Sun? This is a UK news. Is this like a equivalent of like the Globe or the National Enquirer or whatever?
It's some sort of tabloid.
Yeah, it has to be.
They put articles about bulldogs eating genitals next to an article that says, woman reveals what those weird shoulder buttons on coats are really for. You just kind of throwing everything out there, huh?
I guess.
Very similar.
I just sent you guys a snap, by the way.
Drew, this is your genitals.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I want you to know that it's still there. No bulldog got in here.
I don't see the problem. Maybe if I look again. This is weird as fuck.
Yeah, it's real.
I don't
real
like
odd.
This.
Yep. And that's just there for me. Let me refresh the page and see if I can get some new ads in here. Oh, now I got a tiny baby hand.
Mom shares photos of
it's
dead
still
son
fucking
born
there.
At 14
God
weeks.
Damn it.
Okay, hold on. Drew, come back.
Zoo horror moment. Bear rips wolf to pieces in zoo.
Drew, come back.
Where was I? I'm sorry.
The poo watch.
I don't know.
Drug dealer. The toilet.
Okay. All right. So we got to make a hero. Obviously, we need a some redeeming arc for this person. Because do we want to do what it is with, like, the drugs? Something with the drugs?
Yeah, I think we have to.
No, it's not so much a superpower, but what if this person cannot ever poop again?
Does he never have to eat again, then?
No, he has to eat.
So how does he poop it out if he can never poop?
I don't know. Maybe the power runs off food. I don't know. Like maybe the instead of getting excreted out of his that whole situation, maybe whatever his power is another way to expel it, I suppose, or get rid of that energy or whatever. I don't know. I guess we don't want to do anything that shoots food out.
But it like gives him super strength, and he has to use he has to physically exert in order to use up like the food.
Yeah, he could like sweat it out or breathe it out. There are a few ways you can get stuff out of you. Just a few.
There's a few.
I don't know. He could still poop though.
Maybe it's not drugs in there. Maybe it's something else.
Oh, but whatever's. But why doesn't he want to poop it out? Is it something?
I don't know. Here, allow me to read to you what they think he was eating.
Okay.
Last week, it was revealed that he had been eating Frosty's cereals bar.
Okay.
And as time went on, he would eat up to 8 of them a day.
Oh shit!
But
how is he not pooping?
Well, no, but this is. Oh, because it's been 34 days. Oh, sorry. I thought that was prior to his arrest, as though they were like, "What else could be in there? You think it's drugs? What else is he eating?
Frosties? Is that like frosted wheat or no? Wait.
I don't know. Frosties, is that like frosted flakes? But
frosted flakes. That's what I'm thinking.
Hilariously British.
Well, I hear they're great.
Oh no, we're getting sued.
Oh no, here it comes down the wire. Yep. Sorry about that.
Yep, that is frosted flakes.
Do we want to avoid drugs?
No, I'm fine with drugs.
Well, I love drugs.
You're here first, motherfucker. That's right. You're under arrest.
We got him, boys.
Shit. You finally got me.
Tanner, don't try and run.
Damn it.
Yeah. Yeah.
I've been so careful.
But let's finish this episode first before we actually drag you away.
All right.
Yeah, one last good deed before you go away forever.
So maybe he's super drugged out.
But how is that a power?
PCP gives you power.
Does it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, what?
Super strength?
I don't know how PCP works. Is that the angel dust one?
Yeah, that's the stuff where like cops could like tase you 5 times and you just keep coming at them.
Oh shit. All right. So
yeah. I'm telling you, like, you gotta try it.
I like the idea of like invincibility almost, or like heightened I feel like it's been a long time since we've done like honest to God, like normal like superpowers. We've done someone that like a bear that swallowed. I don't know how that one worked. I guess it's not really a superpower, but the contact lens wasn't really, I don't know. She could just see stuff.
It's kind of powers,
I guess.
She was able to influence them with the Reese's Puffs, I believe.
She bribed them.
That's right.
I like the stronger pain tolerance or something like that. That's a good one. But also, this person, should they be like more lethargic and drugged out, or should they be more? Since the drugs have been in his body, maybe those effects go away, but keeps the good.
Yeah, I mean, it could be like he swallowed some experimental drugs, not knowing what they were.
Oh,
swallowed a bunch of cough syrup,
Robitussin.
He just opened his medicine cabinet and just started taking things and didn't care what.
I like experimental.
So high right now. That's cough syrup. You're an idiot.
I like experimental drugs. That gives us more to play with. And also isn't like a big advocate for drugs, even though we've definitely talked about heroin.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, we did. Yeah. So is it like he's a drug dealer and he's like run out of drugs? So he like broke into a local science lab and just took whatever he could find.
Oh.
And when he was on his way to like deal drugs at the playground, he gets pulled over. He's like, oh, shit, and just swallows the whole bag.
Yeah. So and I guess he just doesn't want to get in trouble. So
I don't know if we have to put the poo thing in.
Well, I like the idea that he can poop again. Let's just do that. We'll say that. But I like the idea that he holds it in, and that's what really makes them kick off.
As though if he had just gone to the bathroom, it would have passed through his system and would have felt very little ill effects. But because he held it in for 34 days, it like fused with his DNA. Yeah.
So what can he do? What's our hero's like niche?
Is he unbreakable?
He's Bruce Willis.
Yeah. Well, I don't mean Bruce Willis, but I mean like that kind of power where like he could get hit by a car and he'd be fine.
That would be fun. He's just invincible, but like, is that it? I think usually we get a little more creative. I like that. Is there anything else we can add to it that's fun? And he farts.
He's got frosted flakes for skin.
He turns into a tiger. Oh, what if maybe that's what it is. He dresses up as a tiger and that's his costume to be his biggest icon, Tony the Tiger.
So he loves Tony the Tiger.
Because he clearly loves those Frosties.
He loves them. He loves them.
And then what?
And then he just runs around. He's supposed to be a hero. And he just stops cars. Just jumps in front. He's not fast or anything.
Much too fast.
He's not fast or anything.
So, Nate thinks someone's driving too fast. So, like, if you just see someone in a residential area going too fast, he just, like, steps in front of them.
Yeah.
F's up their car and says, next time, keep it at 25, and then just walks away.
So this made him like largely immovable. He's like an immovable rod.
Actually, I'm thinking of something else we need to define. If he can stop the car, that means he's like able to ground himself, and that implies that he's got some strength. Otherwise,
he just gets smoked
and he flies, but he's fine.
And then, like, the people get out of the car and run over to see if he's okay. And then he's like, that's why you should follow the speed limit.
Oh, so he's a... Oh, damn. That one, Walter something, Weatherman from White. Arrested Development.
Walter White, yeah.
Yeah, Walter White.
I do like this idea that you've sort of come up with, though, that, like, maybe we don't need to make him have grounding. Like, he needs to find create. Like, he can't take damage. He cannot take damage. But he does not have super strength. So he needs to figure out ways, like, okay, I'll jump off the building and land on the villain. And maybe the inertia or, like, the gravity will make me enough to hurt him.
And, like, he's great in hostage situations because he can be like, take me. And then he can wrestle with them. And what are they going to do?
I have a question. If you were doing a hostage situation and then somebody volunteered to be your hostage, would you maybe be like, no?
Isn't that
wait, no?
Yeah, but what that happens all the fucking time in the movies. Like the hostage negotiator is just like, I'm coming in, putting my gun down, let them all out. I'll stay here. You know?
Oh, I thought you meant that somebody was inside. Okay, imagine that somebody was holding a bank hostage. Mm-hmm. And the robber took somebody from inside who was like a customer was like, hey, use me as a hostage for the police out there. And the guy who was holding him would be like, oh no.
Oh shit.
What? No.
What if he's in jail right now? What if they discover what's happening to him and he just joins the police as like he goes in and can defuse the situation? Like he's the guy who can lay down on the bombs. He's the guy who can like go in and one man take down an army. Maybe. Unless they tie him up. That's bad.
Yeah, he's...
yeah, no super strength.
I don't know.
He joins the police?
That's just something we could play with. What do you guys think?
What does he do that the police are like, okay, you can join us now? Does he keep throwing himself in front of speeding cars?
They discover there's one bad guard in there. And the guard like is just like, you know what, I've had enough of your shit. And he tries to kill him. But then the guy won't die. And then that guard gets fired, of course, then probably arrested. But now they're like, all right, well, hey, good news. There's a new guard position open. And they want to keep him on because it's so his powers are so unique.
So.
Or we could do something else.
So then he's a prison guard?
You know, we all start somewhere.
Yeah, I guess we all did start as prison guards, didn't
we?
Yeah,
yeah.
I remember high school.
I don't know. What else we got?
That can work. But then how does that result in him throwing himself out of a speeding car?
So if there's a high-speed chase going on, you know how police call ahead and be like, all right, get the spikes ready.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, why was I, keep going. I want you to take this. Keep going. I won't step in front of your proverbial vehicle right now. So your metaphorical vehicle.
Like the spike chain thing, like it's stuck and they can't roll it out.
And so he just jumps out.
He's like, "I got this."
But again, we get, it's not going to stop the car. We got, I forget.
I know, but like,
oh, I got it. I got it though. I got it. What if he lays down and the tire runs him over and he like gets all wrapped up in there and it stops the car? He's like a human boot.
Think of the money we'll save by not having to waste money on those spike strips. He'll yeah, throw
spike
him in
strips,
there.
He's a boot.
He can't die.
If they need to, like, if they need to boot a vehicle, he just grabs onto the tire and won't move. You know?
It's kind of like a waste of his abilities.
Well, we all start somewhere.
He keeps saying that. I do like the picture, though, of him, like, there's spike strip, it doesn't work, or, like, it's they forgot working. It or something. He's like, oh, shit, I'll take care of it.
There's children in that car, we gotta stop it. And he's just like, step back. And he thinks he's gonna stop it. But what he ends up doing is just, like, getting hit and, like, going through the windshield and, like, taking the perp out.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, that'd stop it.
I still like the image of him getting hit and, like, just flying in the air.
Oh, no doubt that's gonna happen.
He's got to practice a couple times before he really perfects it.
Yeah, there's a montage.
Okay, so what else is he doing?
What else do cops do?
Direct traffic.
Okay, so he's at the busiest intersection, the one that, like, every single time they send someone out there, that cop gets hit.
They should quit sending cops out there.
Or we send in our guy. This place is known as the Devil's Intersection. And they send him in.
The only one man can fix the Devil's Intersection.
Yeah.
He could. Well, you already mentioned. Now, okay, hold on. Yeah, you mentioned throwing himself on top of a bomb. But yeah. Wouldn't that. I'm curious. He doesn't have super strength or anything. So wouldn't it just throw him off and explode
and kill everyone? The building?
Well, you know how people in war movies would jump on top of grenades.
I mean, that's. Okay, yeah. That grenade. Sure. But, like, a bomb, I would imagine, is much bigger.
Grenade's a bomb.
He's got you there.
I mean, it is a bomb. It's. I have to look up bomb versus grenade now. Bomb versus...
You're going to find a cool video of bombs fighting grenades.
Oh, shit. Oh, it's so cool. Oh, fuck.
Could... I've got it. They need to breach into a building. Could they just catapult him in? I think if given enough training, this guy, like, if they perfect his, like, sharpshooting, his combat, his hand to hand, he could go into places and, like, help in a situation, and they don't need to worry about him dying. But boy, they really got to think about his mental health, though. It's not worth it if there's nothing to come home to, you know.
Yeah, but I get what you. They could launch him into, like, the top floor of a building where there's, like, a hostage situation going on, and
yeah,
can work his way down, taking everyone out till he gets to the main bad guy.
Or he could airdrop in. He doesn't need a parachute.
That's true.
He's a real money saver.
Do you think he feels pain at all?
I feel like he has to not. Otherwise, why would you do this?
Maybe it's just discomfort. It's like ooh, when you tweak your knee, ouch. Oof.
So he feels it a little bit?
Yeah. I don't
know. Can he get burned?
He doesn't have to. Oh, that would suck. Yeah, that's a good point, Tanner. That is just... Oof, ouch, ouch, ew, oof.
Oof, ouch.
Nah, he can't feel it. We'll just say that.
Okay.
But maybe there's an arc later on where he's like, oh no, that hurt. What's happening?
So he's got to find more drugs. And he just starts doing every drug at every street corner he can find.
Tries to go back to that place.
Tony Stark, Devil in a Bottle arc.
Oh, shit, yeah.
But with drugs.
The Devil's Intersection in a Bottle.
It's really deep.
Yeah. It's a real thinker. Think about it.
Think about it.
So, are we getting rid of Tiger?
I had forgotten about that.
Because so
yes,
far,
I think we're getting rid of it.
Basically, the costume now is a police uniform.
No, he's got to have something, like, at least for when he, like, drops out of a plane to get into a building that where, like...
Sky suit of some kind, like...
He looks like a bullet or something going into the top of that building.
Mm. So he's got a big helmet, and he's very aerodynamic.
How big?
I want numbers. How big is his helmet?
10.
What?
It's so big you could cook an egg on it out there.
Oh shit! You should do comedy.
I know. You think really you should?
You're gonna be great. Okay, so a hat that's ten big, guys. That is a pretty big hat.
It's a pretty big hat.
What else has he got going on?
All right.
Does he have? I just picture like specifically for like when like you were talking to me about like jumping off a building to get enough inertia to like hit someone or something, and then like Drew said jumping in that building from the top, like something that like can pierce through.
So it's a pointed helmet. It's a
very pointy hat.
Yes.
Not like a cowboy hat. Furiously scribbling out a drawing.
This is like,
do you guys something with his arms? So like he's like diving down, he's got like blades on his arms or something to like.
Oh, blades is good. Because I was just thinking this is very similar to the article we did with the woman who had the muffler on her head.
What did she do?
She headbutted
people.
Yeah,
what did she do?
She like headbutted people, I think. I don't know. She had that muffler on her head as a helmet.
Don't remember that one at all. I'll have to go back and listen to it.
Yeah. It's something with left turns. I don't remember. And only left turns.
Was she the one with the sword inside of her cane? The old woman?
Yeah.
Is that what that was?
Yeah. And was also a part train. I like the bladed, like, because if you're diving, you're diving, so you put your hands out front.
Yeah.
Ouch.
That's what I'm saying.
If he can lock those elbows in, he could penetrate. Ew, I hated that.
He's got a little belt on that has some Frosties, Frosty cereal bars.
That's like his. All right, man, we're going to let you out of prison on one condition. You join us. And he's like, all right, I'll take it. On one condition. And then next thing is he's got like a shitload of those Frosty things. Like,
then do they go back and forth and they're like, okay, we'll get you the Frosties, but on one condition. And then they have something.
You have to go pick up my laundry. Okay, I'll go do that on one condition. You pay for parking. All right. That's fine. On one condition. I need a hoagie right now. All right. On one condition. It's wheat because you need to watch your intake. Caloric intake. I don't know if wheat's better for you. I just feel better anytime I get wheat over white.
There's all 9 of your essential nutrients.
Yeah, you would know that.
Thank you. I like that though, because then it was not one condition. It was like 12 conditions each.
Yeah, it's good.
It's good stuff.
Yep. What else? Anything else? Does he? You know, we haven't done it for a while. But does he have a cape?
I think at least when he's like doing the like aerial missions where he's diving in, I think he has to. Yeah.
He's got a, what are those called? Flight suits?
Like a maybe. Flying squirrel suit, isn't that? Maybe I'm making that up.
I think you're just combining an animal.
No, that
with a flight.
Have you ever seen a squirrel fly, Drew? Come on.
What a ludicrous idea.
You ain't right in the head, boy.
That boy ain't right.
Boy ain't right.
I still haven't watched the first episode.
What?
Isn't that the boy ain't right? Isn't that from King of the Hill?
Is it, man? Oh, can we please watch the pilot this weekend?
Dude, I think we're gonna end up watching more than the pilot, if I had to guess.
Yeah. We gotta have a lazy morning where we watch. No doubt, we're gonna have a lazy morning. By the way, we need to. We'll need to talk about that. Wingsuit. That's it.
A squirrel suit.
Wingsuit's good. Well, I think we pretty much got it. What do we want to move except on to cover?
The cover and name, I think.
Cover. What's a good depiction?
what about him getting hit by a car or him getting stuck in the tires of a car? But like the police are looking on, very pleased.
The tires. If he's getting hit by the car and flying away, that makes it look like, oh, that man just died. But if we get him clamped onto that tire and he's like smiling while he does it, you know something super there.
You can have a word bubble be like, I'm not dying.
Yeah, exactly that.
I think that'll get the message across.
And the cops are like, yeah. go. We did it. Crime is down. All thanks to me.
There's a newspaper that's just like kind of off to the side that says crime is down.
They're throwing a party for him. Cake.
There's a lot going on in this cover.
Yeah. But then the one guard who had a beef with him is like watching on in the background like, no, this isn't. And then he becomes the villain.
Wasn't he already kind of a villain, though?
Yeah, he's kind of a dick.
He's like a bad thing.
He's like a tertiary villain. Not superpowered, just a dick. Until he swallows his gun.
Then he became a human with all the powers of a gun.
Yeah, and he wouldn't poop for 34 days. And then he died, because that's just not good.
Yeah. All right. Thinking?
Name?
Let's do it.
He's invincible, of course.
Mm-hmm.
He's a cop. So did we want to do like a sergeant or what's a captain?
That's true.
Crash boy, because he can crash into things.
Ooh, he's a crash dummy.
The crash test dummy,
and they call him that as like a maybe mocking him at first, but then he's like, you know what, that's me, that's who I am. And they, yeah,
so he's crash test dummy.
I mean, that's a solid maybe for me. I think I like that, but I think that is maybe a record for as soon for having needing to get a name and getting it right away. We could play around a little more.
Crash Bandicoot.
All right, well, Crash Bandicop.
The Crash at Demon Head.
The Demon of the Devil's Intersection.
The Devil of the Devil's Intersection.
Oh, hey, this is UK, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
What about, like, Constable Crash?
Oh, shit.
Shit.
Ah, shit.
Ah, fuck. God damn it, I can't believe you've done this.
That's good. Does it sound good to say...
That's a UK thing, right?
Yeah, Constable. Yeah, it is. I'm not sure if it's still... Probably. I don't know. I can, a special, anytime I think a special of a Constable, rank just for him, I think he's of a like monster. Sherlock Holmes or something. What, is it too much to say Constable Crash Dummy?
I think so. I think that's too much.
Too much. All right. All right.
What if we just kept going, though? Maybe we'll wrap back around. Like Constable Crash Dummy for the police.
All right. I'll do that. Except you got to do something for me.
Constable Crash Dummy for the police of the United Kingdom.
And then also his father's from Wales, so there's some royalty on that side too. So there's titles. Yeah. Constable Crash, though. I like it.
Yeah, that was very good, Nate. God damn it.
Thank you.
It's good.
You know, sometimes we've all done it. Sometimes we sit here for 15 minutes.
I've never done that.
And sometimes one of us just says it.
Yeah, and the one that hits us right.
Constable Crash. I like the way that tastes.
Mm. How's it taste?
That's pretty good. A little sweet.
Yeah, it's good.
Also a little sour.
Oh.
Oh.
But like, yeah, in a good way.
But also a little chicken.
Nice.
All right, well, Constable Crash. There it is. That was pretty smooth. I like that.
Smooth.
Well, it looks like we do have another voicemail here. Looks like it's from Jeff, who's called in before. So why don't I just give that a play here? Hold on.
Oh, thanks, Jeff.
Yeah,
thanks for calling in.
Thanks, Jeff.
Appreciate it, Jeff.
What do we have to say about that one?
I think it says, I don't know, I think it speaks for itself, really.
Yeah. I mean, we needed the encouragement, I think.
Yeah. I did want to say that the Google transcript for it is shite, shyt. So I think that's Jeff trying to play into the whole UK theme we got going on, shite.
Yeah.
I'm not sure if that's a...
Probably know, is. Maybe. I don't know. Shit.
I don't know anything about it. Never been.
It was good timing by Jeff.
Yeah. Well, thank you, Jeff, for calling in, giving that thoughtful message. Really appreciate it. I guess that's it. Tanner, can you do that thing? that special thing you do.
Yeah, but first, I think I'll close out the episode first.
Yeah, oh, please. Call. Thank you. Yeah.
So yeah, that concludes issue number 75. Is that what we agreed on?
That is.
Yeah, 75 of Headline Heroes. This week we made a hero, a real hero, one who does drugs. That's what a real hero is.
Real hero right there.
By the name of Constable Crash. It's a Nathan Haynes original. At this time, as always, we'd like to thank Brett Jacobson for creating the art for the show. Brett really likes to wear wet socks.
Now, why though?
So he says he likes the feel. Like he gets up in the morning, puts on some socks, starts his bathtub running, and steps in the tub for a minute, and then puts on his shoes immediately, so they get squishy too.
Wears those for the rest of the day, huh?
Yeah.
That can't smell good.
It does not. That is true.
At this time, we also want to thank Carl Sorensen. Carl did the music for our podcast, including, I don't know if we, did we reference it last week? The super spooky.
I believe we did.
I think we did, but it's worth pointing out again because he.
One more time. Carl did a fantastic job with the theme, spooky theme for last week.
He went for a John Carpenter feel, and I think he nailed it.
I was just going to say you should explain what the feeling was on that one. Which pretend I don't know who John Carpenter is. What movie?
He did a lot of movies. Well, like
what theme is that?
They parody? Live and oh, it's from Halloween specifically. Halloween.
Okay. Thank you.
Well, if you're interested in having Carl make any kind of theme for you, spooky or otherwise, or doing any sort of musical work for you, you can reach out to him at carljsorensen.com.
If you have any articles you'd like to send our way, I'm going to try again. If you have any articles you would like to send our way, please do. We have our email, headlineheroescast@gmail.com. Our Twitter, @headline_heroes, and follow us there. Sometimes we tweet. Sometimes. Our Facebook group, and of course, our subreddit, which is, of course, always bumping. We have a voicemail, which we played two voicemails just today. If you want to call in, literally give us anything, ask us questions, talk about past stuff, or just swear, use profanity. I guess. Yeah, you can do that. So that number is 319-596-6766. So give us a ring there. Leave us a voicemail. Generally, it would be great. Try to keep them shorter. We love all your voicemails, but it's better for us if they're, I don't know, less than a minute or so. That's just better for podcasting reasons, I guess. I don't know.
You're right. I mean, that's a good way to word it.
It's not my day job. Yeah. It's better for the podcast.
There you go.
Whatever you're listening to us on, be it Apple or Google Play or whatever, if you could hit that subscribe button, that'd be great. And tell a friend about us because word of mouth.
That's a good thing.
Thank you. So thank you for listening, and we hope you'll pick up the next issue of Headline Heroes.
Animorphs, Megamorphs number 2 in the Time of Dinosaurs, chapter 1.
All right, so Marco. We're gonna be...
My name is Marco, and I'm the idiot who happened to be watching the news on TV and happened to see the story about the nuclear submarine that went down.